athletes or rappers. Whatever you choose, whatever you do, make sure he a thug and intelligent too, like a real thoroughbred is. Show me love, let me feel. Females who's the is always, and I like a little sassiness, a lot of class. Mommy reaching your bag, past the, I'm a leader at last. This a don you with my spit, lose consciousness.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
82 regular season games, three rounds of the playoffs to get right here. It's the NBA Finals, and now all of it comes down to this historic Game 7. Ernie Johnson here, along with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille. And the series tonight takes place in Oakland, where it'll be the Warriors going up against the Toronto Raptors. Checking out Toronto, a crucial home win for them to tie the series. They force a Game 7 here on the road. The odds stacked against them as they look for a way to steal the series. And now we've reached Game 7, winner take all. You've both played in a number of these over your careers. What is the key to sealing the deal in that decisive Game 7?
Well, when it's down to a one-game season, Ernie, and it's anyone's game, the biggest thing you have to do is go possession by possession. And you can't change the thing, Shaq, that got you there. A lot of guys like to change up. Oh, it's Game 7. The only one who should change up is your best player. He should say, I wanted a little bit more today. That's about it.
The coach that comes in and talks about plays is the one that's nervous. The one that comes in and said, listen, we've seen a lot of each other. We know each other inside and out. We got to go hit them, get to the biggest shots, crucial moments, take advantage of them, and we will bring home the series.
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
In the history of the NBA,
right,
the home team wins Game 7 what percentage of the time?
Upper 70s.
I would say probably about 87%.
I think it's closer to you. It's 80%. 80% of the time the home team wins Game 7.
Dr. O'Neal, upper 70, a.k.a. rounded off.
Yeah. I said lower 80s.
No, you said 87.
Yeah.
I did check the tape.
Yeah, you said 87.
Check the tape.
Yeah,
I said lower.
I'm always right.
Check the tape. I said lower 80.
Producer says you said 87.
Oh, okay.
That's it for now. Thank you for joining us. 87%.
Stars have aligned on the biggest night in basketball. This series has gone down to the wire. The air is thick with excitement and anticipation. Welcome, everyone, to NBA Finals Game 7. Winner take all. A season of joy and pain will end here tonight. And thank you for making us part of your night on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. Doris Burks on the sideline as well. Take a look at the Warriors. They have tried mightily throughout the long NBA season and now center stage exactly where they want to be. The home court advantage could play a big part, guys, in this.
And guys, it's been a journey. I mean, they've battled all season to get here. And maybe it's taken them longer than they would have liked in the NBA Finals, having to go all the way to a Game 7. But they are here. They're at home in front of this crazy crowd, four quarters away from the title.
Yeah, and you know what? The key, Greg, for me is you've got to perch yourself in the present. You can't get caught up in the emotion going throughout the building here. This is an emotional crowd. There's no denying that. They're even more fired up than I expected them to be, but the players have to find a way to quiet themselves and get locked into their business.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. So the Raptors five right now. Be out there with Marc Gasol. Then there's Baller. Then there's Lowry. And it's Ariza in a small forward.
That's not a sight you see very often. I mean, he has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when he's open. If they could end every possession with that shot, they'd be happy. 9 times out of 10, that's an easy layup for them.
And so here's Toronto. After the miss from Klay Thompson. Outside Lowry. Fires from deep. Rebounded by Curry. Warriors have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Kicks it to Barnes. Back to Curry. Beyond the arc. And that one's good. Curry. He's got five.
And a really good way to start the game. He's a guy who, if he gets it going early, he's going to give you problems.
Pass the ball. Fires the three, and he gets the bucket.
Tit for tat right there, huh, guys?
Didn't take him long at all, fellas, to get those 3 points back.
Bogut sends a screen for Curry. Pass to Bogut. He dishes it to Barnes. Bogut on the triple. Toronto's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. He passes to Ariza. The tray. The shot will not go. So Golden State will take it the other way. They come into this one after losing on Sunday.
And with the number of turnovers they had in that game, guys, it was going to be an uphill battle all the way.
Especially when you couple the turnovers with the soft defense they were playing. That's a losing combination.
Lowry with the ball. Picked up by Thompson. Lowry passes to Pete. Good looking screen by Gasol. There's the feed to Ariza. It's good. This game is all even. Ariza's got his first bucket of the night. Warriors have gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. Curry against Lowry. Outside Curry. Nobody near Barnes. That's basket number 2 with his third shot off to a fast 2 for 3. Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Now Lowry, quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Passes to Pete. 6 on the shot clock. Goes up on the wing. It's hauled in by Bogut. The Warriors have gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%. Green with a screen on Lowry. That one rolling around and rims out.
Good pick, but he just couldn't make it count.
Yeah, nice job of setting the screen by his teammate there. I'm sure he appreciated it.
Ariza no luck. The Warriors leading. Barnes kicks to Thompson. And oh, here we go. Lowry's got the fast break chance. And he jams it with authority.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
That indicates the importance of great on-the-ball defense, as was displayed right there. Offensively, he can be the engine that drives them at any given time.
Pass to ball inside the 8-footer. It's rebounded by Golden State. Now here's Thompson. Barnes with it. He's picked up by Ariza. Thompson blanketed by the D. He fights to the rim for the layup. Thompson's got his second basket of the night. Raptors trail by 4. And here's Lowry. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. The dish now to Ariza. Pass to ball. Gasol a screen. Off the pick. Shot misses. The Warriors go the other way.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
A 3 from Barnes. A rebound by Gasol. Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
He had a nice open look right there.
How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
Warriors have gotten 6 of 11 shots to go down so far. Pretty nice shooting. Green with a screen for Kerr. To the paint. Green dishes to Bogut. Screen by Bogut. Thompson from long range. It's rebounded by Kyle Lowry.
Kevin, I didn't like that defensive effort at all, but they're lucky he missed it.
Yeah, you hope that's not indicative of the type of D they're going to play, because if they do, they're going to have struggles with him tonight.
The Warriors making a switch here. Spates has checked in. And Toronto also making a switch. Ibaka has checked in. And Doris Burke spoke with Steve Kerr. Doris?
He told me that as hard as it may be to believe, in an atmosphere as intense as Game 7 of the NBA Finals, it's almost hard to be nervous. There's just too much going on. He said, we're ready to get to the task at hand. We know exactly what we need to do. Can they do it? That's the question, Kevin.
Thanks again, Doris. Curry against Lowry. Lets it go from the wing. No good. That's miss number two. He's one for three. A shot by Thompson and no one's around. And he didn't get quite enough under that one. Dishes it to Ariza. He guarded by Spates.
You know, there are a lot of bigger power forwards than him in the NBA, but very few that rise up like he can.
Here's Curry, 5 points in the game. Can't get it to fall. Ball, he's covered by Thompson. Some nice ball movement here by the Raptors. Here's P. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
Boy, oh boy, to be young again. My, oh my. Got me thinking back to my days.
Oh, yeah, and right. It does make you nostalgic, doesn't it? Oh,
well, man. Speak for yourself. I could never throw it down like that, but I will say it sure looks fun, doesn't it?
And Toronto has possession. 3-point lead. Here's Baller. Off target with his three.
He's going to play his way right onto the bench and out of the game if he continues to shoot it like he has so far in this quarter.
It's Curry with the drive. Tries to snap the cold streak, and it's Green missing.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Wow. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a 3-point play.
Done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball into the paint.
Clearly, they've been the aggressors thus far when it comes to attacking the interior in this first half.
And some changes here for the Warriors. Andre Iguodala. He's checked in for Barnes. Barbosa comes in for Thompson. And it's Livingston in for Curry. And then for Toronto, Luis Scola. He's checked in for P. And Damari Carroll subbed in for Trevor Ariza. And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for Toronto.
And so far, these guys have done a fantastic job finding the open man and getting some easy baskets.
Something else they've done a good job of tonight, you know, right from the start, is penetrating and scoring.
And both free throws good for Green. Raptors leading by four. Outside Lowry. Ibaka with a screen on Spates. Lowry passes to Ibaka. Knocked loose. Here's Scola. And he drops in the layup off the glass. And the Raptors lead by six.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Here's Iguodala, and count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
In that tight, with that much of an advantage height-wise, there's just not a lot the defense can do.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. And Iguodala, no good on that one. And it's the Raptors' ball. They're on a 12-4 run. Outside for Lowry. They get the rebound. Scola feeds it to Carroll. And it's Spates with the rebound.
I tell you what, that's too good a look to pass up there. Even though it didn't go, that's one you got to take.
Here is Livingston. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Let's take this chance now to show you the list of the postseason scoring leaders.
You take a look at Baller, second in the league, having an excellent season.
Well, he's almost unstoppable. He's got so many different ways he can hurt you and put the ball in the basket. And it seems as though he raises his level during the postseason.
And he knocks down the first one. And Barbosa drops them both. Raptors with the lead. Lowry with the ball. He has six. He kicks it to Scola. He feeds it to Carroll. Tries it from nine. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. And the Raptors lead by four.
He can be a matchup nightmare if he can get it in the paint.
Livingston kicks to Green. Green with a screen for Iguodala. Green with a screen on Carroll. Iguodala, that's good.
And he came off that screen, and the D just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg. And when that's the case, you can mark those up for him.
And Toronto has possession. Baller passes to Carroll. Kicks it to Lowry. Taken away. Down low, here's Barbosa. That one fall. Coming off Iguodala's feed. And this game is tied up now.
Love the assist. I mean, he knew exactly where that bounce pass had to be to create that opportunity.
Now Lowry passes it to Ball. Down to five on the shot clock. Fades and shoots. It's rebounded by Golden State.
Not a quarter to remember as far as his offense is concerned.
Yeah, you know, he's not making any kind of impact for them at that end of the court right now.
Green, the screen, off the screen. And unable there to get the go-ahead bucket.
Yeah, great look, but disappointing with the miss.
Boy, what happened on that one, Greg? I mean, that's almost an automatic shot for him.
And Carroll gets it to go.
It's been a very efficient first quarter for him. He's creating good opportunities and converting those that he creates.
Barbosa kicks to Green. And the powerful one-handed slam.
Superb assist there. He played the role of the maestro on that one.
The Raptors shooting it well so far today, guys. They've connected on 48% of their shots. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Ibaka with a screen on Barbosa. Baller passes to Ibaka. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. And it goes on Draymond Green.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact.
Exactly. The defense determined not to allow the easy layup right there. They'll settle for making him earn the free throw.
The first free throw is good. Both of them.
He has such terrific form and consistency on his free throw. Beautiful to watch.
Here is Livingston. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Here's Spates. True on the 14-footer.
Just no chance for the smaller defender to block that shot.
He's really, really good at using his size to free himself up for those mid-range jumpers. A master at it.
It's a tie game here in Oakland. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. Welcome back to this Game 7 as we get ready to get back into the action. What do you guys think about the Warriors here so far?
You know, it's been about how solid they've been offensively here, really tuned in with one another.
Good ball movement, and it's paid off on the scoreboard.
Now, here's Lowry. It's the Splash Brothers, Curry and Thompson. They're in the backcourt. Iguodala, the three, with Barnes, the stretch four. And it's Bogut, and at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the Warriors' foul.
I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
The Raptors have gone 3 for 3 at the line tonight. And that one falls for Marc Gasol. And so Gasol nails them both.
Boy, I tell you what, he does not look like your typical big man up there at the line. He has an excellent stroke and a percentage to match.
Now, here's Thompson. Down low. It's stolen by Lowry. Johnson left side. And stolen by Barnes. And here we go. Fast break. Curry's got it. Iguodala dishes to Curry. Got a piece of it. Fast break, Toronto. Here's P, powered down with both hands.
And guys, that's a big swing right there. I mean, taking the steal and then turning it into two easy points on the dunk.
No telling how important that sequence could turn out to be.
And guys, in a game this snug, moments like that are the ones we usually look back on at the end as a difference maker.
Now, here is Lowry after the miss from Stephen Curry. Gasol inside. Bogut on him. Nice D from Bogut.
Oh, tough D on the inside.
It sure was, Greg. No easy access to the basket when that fella's in the middle.
Raptors leading by 4. Johnson outside. From beyond the arc, Marc Gasol picks up the foul. That's his first foul.
Yeah, he was boxed out and tried to get the rebound the only way he could.
Yeah, he got straight over the back and on top of him there, too. So nothing subtle about that one.
And we're now about a minute and a half into the second quarter. And here is Curry. He has 5. And here's Barnes for 3. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Curry's got 3 assists tonight. The Raptors have gone 1 of 3 to start out the second quarter. Lowry kicks to Carroll. Quarter number 2, we're about 2 minutes in. Back to Lowry. 5 to shoot. Pulls up from the corner. Good! Lowry's got his 3rd bucket of the night. Warriors trail by 3. Outside Curry. Golden State moving the ball around. Iguodala kicks to Curry. Golden State needs to get off a shot. Barnes can't get it to go. Raptors leading by 3. Outside Lowry. Gasol is screen. Lowry passes to Gasol. Here's P. Can't get it to go. Good defense by Iguodala. The Warriors shooting here about 46% for the game. And stolen by Kyle Lowry. Johnson against Curry. From the arc. It's Lowry again missing.
He hit a 3 in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Knocks it loose. Iguodala kicks to Barnes. That misses. Had a chance to tie it there.
Well, that defense went from poor to no defense at all.
And when he's open like that, you don't see him miss those looks very often.
He just has not been able to get into that groove yet, guys. But as a whole,
it hasn't affected them too much.
Thompson with the bucket. Closing in on 4 minutes played here in the second quarter. Outside Lowry. Outside Gasol. Back to Lowry. From deep three-point range. That's Lowry again missing.
It would have been something to see if he could hit that shot from that deep.
Greg, you know it. I know it. There aren't very many guys that can hit from out there. But he is one of them. That's the kind of range he has.
And so here's Toronto. After the missed three from Stephen Curry. Johnson, wide open. He fires. Sinks the three-pointer. Warriors trail by four. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Now here's Barnes. He has seven. Pass to Bogut. His first shot coming late. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good.
And a sharp pass to set up that high percentage shot in close.
Thompson against Lowry. He dishes it to Johnson. Outside Gasol. Gasol setting the pick for Carroll. Nice D from Bogut.
And honestly, not real happy with the shot selection on that one.
Yeah, clearly a brain fade there. He's got to be a little smarter in his choice making.
Barnes can't get it to go.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Lowry dishes to Gasol. Here's P. Goes straight through the defender for the dunk. Draws the foul. He'll go to the line. That one on Thompson.
Went for the two-hander on that slam. That's where the weight room comes into play, Kevin.
I think some urgency from him there.
Hey, I think he's sensing that this is a critical time in the game, fellas.
Spates checked in for Thompson. Trevor Ariza's checked in for the Raptors. Waller comes in for Damari Carroll. And the free throw, no good. Warriors trail by four to the inside. Here's Barnes. It's deflected. They retain possession. Out to the wing. Left side Curry. Down to five on the shot clock. Jacks up a three. And there's Barnes. That's good on the assist by Curry. Curry's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Toronto's gone 1-6 from three-point land in the second quarter. Less than 20%, but they've continued to let him fly. Lowry gets to Gasol. P, guarded by Spates. Here's P. Bounces high off the rim and drops. P's got 12 in the game.
And after his last game, really not surprised to see him as hot as he is here tonight.
And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here.
You know what? I think he thinks he can make a few improvements to how things are going on right now.
Yeah, and you know, coaches always are looking for ways to tweak things and change it up a little bit, no matter what the situation is. That's what coaches do.
Catching up on the changes for Golden State. Draymond Green, he's checked in for Bogut. Barbosa comes in for Andre Iguodala. And it's Livingston in for Steph Curry. Now here is Barbosa. Spates sets a screen. Here is Livingston. Now recovering. A three from Barnes. Score of the basket, his fifth of the game. He's missed six shots against those five bigs.
And he's now made 3 three-pointers here in the second, starting to get it going.
Outside Lowry. Ariza passes to Ibaka. The feed to Lowry. The kick out to Scola. It's stolen by Green. And oh, here we go with Green. Nobody down. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far. Two shots. No good on that one. So we can't get either to fall. Toronto shooting 38% in the second quarter. Offensively, they look a little bit confused. Screen by Stoa. Lowry kicks to Stoa. The pass to Ball. From 12 feet out. Shot no good. And Golden State will come the other way. Livingston dishes to Barbosa. It's up a three. Toronto grabs the miss. Lowry kicks to Ibaka. A three. That's in, coming off an assist from Lowry. Lowry's got three assists now in this one.
And when you've got a big man who can shoot from distance like that, what a huge advantage.
Now here's Spates. Barbosa kicks to Barnes. They kick it out to Green. Golden State moving it around. Fades back. Not enough on that one as it misses.
You could tell he assumed he'd be able to beat the defensive coverage even though it was all over.
Here is Livingston, now recovering. Out to the right wing. Here's Barnes, and it's blocked by Ibaka. And so it looks like the Warriors will retain possession here. Here's the screen. Six to shoot. Barbosa for three.
You know, his shooting percentage has fallen off here in the second. He just can't get the ball in the basket. He's really struggling.
Lowry from outside. And the Raptors hit again from deep.
And really, how about the quick release on that triple there? Because he's given up a lot of height in that matchup.
Right on target you are, Greg. I mean, the quick release is what made the difference there. Any hesitation, and that shot is being blocked.
Yeah, none too pleased with the play of his team. And you know what? They just need to get things sorted out.
Yeah, you know, there's not a coach around who would be happy with the way his guys have kind of rolled over during this run.
Livingston still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Barnes, and down it goes. Jamming that one home.
Check out the bounce.
Bounce to the ounce. Clark, how about that?
Yeah.
All right.
You
showing
said
him
it,
off
Kevin.
Right there. Good move.
You said it, my man. He's a highlight reel waiting to happen.
Raptors leading by four. Lowry passes to Ball. Pass to Ibaka. And there's a foul. It's on Maurice Spates. That is his first foul of the game.
I mean, I like the call. I thought the defense was just there a little late.
Yeah, it looked like it. I mean, he kind of slid underneath as he got to the spot, too.
Golden State on D. Four-point game. Green with the rebound.
And it's just one of those days, guys. He has just struggled to shoot the basketball.
That's good.
And that's how the coach would draw it up on the fast break from start to finish.
Yeah, and what a finish it was, guys. Really nicely done.
The Warriors have shot 4 of 7 as a team from the line tonight. Several misses early. That one misses for Spates.
Wow. Wow. If I were a coach, I could just only shake my head. They have been absolutely awful from the line this quarter.
Now, Here's Lowry. 11 points in the game. Kicks it out to Ariza. 4 on the clock. Looking to end his cold spell. And that one's good. Waller's got his second basket of the night. Here is Livingston. Now recovering. Spates sets a screen. Now here is Barbosa. He's guarded closely. Out left of the wing. That's a 2 from Barnes. Set it up with the fake, but it's offline. Ball covered by Barbosa. Here's the dish to Ariza. The Raptors rebound. Warriors trail by 4. Feeds it to Livingston. Dishes it to Spates. And it's Toronto with the rebound. Lowry's got his 4th rebound in this one. There's 42 seconds left in the first half. Stole it down low, headed by Green. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
For Toronto, they have shot 5 of 6 at the foul line tonight. He makes the first. And he makes both free throws. Warriors trail by 6. Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cottonmouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Here is Livingston. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Barnes can't get it to go.
It just hasn't been a very good day for him, guys. They need him to start burying some of those.
Baller. And we finish one half of basketball. Toronto ahead. They're up by 6. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Okay, Kevin, here with Coach Casey. And Coach, you've done a tremendous job forcing turnovers and getting into your transition game. What do you tell your guys to keep them to keep doing what they're doing?
Push the ball. We always want to push the ball. That's the stop. But again, we got to make good decisions. We don't want to come down and give it right back to them and let them run it down our throats to the end. Run the ball, wings get out and run, pass it ahead, but then make good decisions and attack the basket.
Coach, thanks for the time. Gentlemen, back to you.
Thank you, Doris. And we'll be right back after halftime for the start of quarter number 3.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Well, we certainly hope you enjoyed the first half. There's nothing like the NBA Finals. I'm Ernie Johnson with Kenny Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. For the Raptors, they've been playing extremely tough, and you can feel that they believe they can come away tonight with the championship. If they come out of the locker room with that same emotion we saw in the first half, they may very well do just that. And taking a look at the Raptors, Kenny, what did you see out there?
Well, quite simply, their bench showed up tonight. And when I say showed up, I'm talking about on the offensive end, because they were scoring in bunches. Now, you want your reserves to just at least come in and hold the fort, but they did way more than that tonight.
Shaq, what are your thoughts on Golden State?
Well, their poor rebounding is really hurting them. It hasn't killed them on the scoreboard yet, but they need to pick it up. This is a game they can win. If they come out hustling in the second half, they can win.
And that's going to do it for now, as the second half is just about to get started. Now back to Kevin Harlan and the rest of the 2K Sports crew. We will see you later.
Welcome back to our coverage of the NBA Finals. More action straight ahead.
Some terrific work by Barnes. He has 15 points, and he sprayed home 3 three-pointers as well.
This is really production personified from long range.
Raptors leading by 6. So the Raptors 5 right now. Trevor Ariza out there with P, and it's Marc Gasol. Then there's Baller, and it's Lowry in at the 1. Ariza outside. 6 on the shot clock. Here's P. Off target from 3-point range.
Boy, from my angle, it looked like it was in the bottom of the net. Looked good from here.
Yeah, I'm about as shocked as you are, Clark.
Kicks it to Barnes. Rebound by the Raptors. P's got his 3rd rebound tonight after shooting 43% from the floor. Passes the ball. And shot on the way. He kicks it to Ariza. A 3-ball. That's good. Ariza's got the 1st bucket of the 3rd here for Toronto.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Everybody on the same page, completely in sync, tremendous communication and awareness.
He lobs up the alley-oop pass. Out of bounds, Golden State takes possession.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. Terrible turnover.
Here's Curry. He's got 5. He feeds it to Barnes, 11 feet away, and it's Gasol with the rebound. Gasol's got 3 rebounds now in this one. Baller passes to Lowry. To the middle. 7-foot shot. It's deflected, and he's able to get it back. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Ariza. And we're just about 2 minutes into the 2nd half now. Curry against Ariza. Curry kicks to Barnes. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. And that's now 18 points for Barnes. Toronto leading by 6. Lowry passes to Baller. Ariza a screen on Thompson. Here's Baller. And it's Klay Thompson with the rebound. Thompson's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Curry dishes to Thompson. Back to Curry. Soft touch off the glass. And now it's just a 4-point Toronto lead.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
You're right, Clark. Just continue to pound it in the paint and get those easy points inside.
Now here is Lowry. He's got 11. Gasol kicks to Lowry. Clock at 4. So the whistle blows on the shot and 2 free throws for the contact right there.
And a big game for Pete. He has 12 points. And he has 1 steal to his credit as well.
And Clark, he's just done a great job defensively. That 1 steal doesn't tell the whole story.
For Toronto, they have been good at the free throw line. This one, 7 of 8. And the 1st one drops. Andre Iguodala is checked in for the Warriors. Trail by 6. Outside Curry. From outside the arc. It's rebounded by Gasol.
Boy, but he was close, Kevin, to making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, you may not be as lucky next time down if you're the defense. You cannot allow him to get those kinds of looks.
What are they thinking, leaving him with all that space out there? Do they not know? Have they not heard that this guy is unbelievable? That's a layup for him.
And Green gets it to go.
How about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
Outside Lowry. The pass to Ball. He dishes it to Gasol. Pass to Beat. Five on the clock. Raptors need to get a shot up. Takes the three. The Warriors pull it in, and they're running. Here's Thompson, got a hand on it.
And they continue to control the glass.
Guys, I think they've simply been the more physical team, and that's why they're ahead.
And Lowry gets it to go. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for the Raptors.
You know, block shots, guys, a clear indicator on the stat sheet of their excellent defense. I mean, leaving them no room to get off any shots.
Yeah, but they've been offensive defensively tonight because they've really forced the issue on D and come up with quite a few steals and deflections.
Some changes for Toronto. James Johnson checked in for Ariza, and Damari Carroll subbed in for Kyle Lowry. Warriors trail by 10. It's Curry with the drive. And it's out of bounds. The Warriors able to retain possession here. Looking to get back on track here. Covered by Thompson. And now here comes Iguodala leading the break. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
It's as if the defense just let him go.
He'll thank them for that because he got a chance to perform a little razzle-dazzle on that one.
Now here's Carroll. Six to shoot. He's covered by Thompson. Klay Thompson grabs the miss.
Yeah, but the hand in the face. It's critical that you can test his shots every time down the floor.
No one near Curry as he lets it go. Curry with another miss.
He's still looking for his first three-pointer of the second half after making just one in the first.
Gasol a screen. Baller passes to Gasol. The Raptors rebound. Passes it to Baller. To the left wing, Carroll, no one around him. Nailed from three-point land. Carroll's got 7 points. Warriors trail by 11. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points. 4 of their last 5 makes came off of a high-quality shot inside.
Textbook. Really, would you look at how they're playing? They are having their way down low.
So it's Toronto now. Pass it to Kira. Key, guarded by Green. Pass to Johnson. It's tipped. Iguodala with the steal. Now the Warriors moving it up. A shot by Curry, no good.
And that's the way you want to defend. Nice job there.
Always important to have that good interior defense.
Johnson attacking. There's the feed to Gasol. Shot clock at 6. Johnson against Boak. And the shot is good from Johnson. Johnson's got the lead up to 11 now for the Raptors.
And you can tell they're just a little out of sync. I think he just wants to get everybody back on the same page.
Yeah, I like this timeout, Greg. I think it's a good one because It looks like they need a minute to talk things through here.
And the Warriors making a change here. Spates has checked in. Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for the Raptors. Golden State's gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. Curry dishes to Thompson. Spates kicks to Iguodala. Feeds to Curry. And good as it just snugs right down through the net.
Easy little jumper for him right there, guys.
Ball. He's covered by Thompson. And that one's good. And that's 10 points for Baller. Warriors trail by 11. Now the dish to Bogut. Screen by Bogut. Curry attacking. Toronto grabs the miss. Johnson's got his third rebound on the night. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. That's on Andrew Bogut. Raptors have gone 9 of 10 from the line, so making the most of their chances. The first one falls.
Take a look at what Carroll's done. He's got 8 points, and he's put 1 3-pointer on the board.
You know what, though, Clark? It wouldn't be a bad idea going forward to try to let him do a little more damage from beyond the arc.
And the Warriors making a change here. Barbosa's checked in. And he makes both free throws.
Can you believe the job they're doing at the foul line since halftime? I mean, they've been perfect so far.
Yeah, as cool as can be, Clark. Great focus and efficiency. That's how they built this lead.
Now, here is Barbosa. Dishes it to Iguodala. Nice teamwork to set up the pick play and make the space for the Jays.
How about Bogut doing a good job setting that screen?
Raptors leading by 11. Kicks it to Carroll. The pass to Ball. He feeds it to Ibaka. He kicks it to Carroll. Tries it from 19. And all around the rim that time before dropping in. Carroll's got 11 points.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the lead.
Shoots from the elbow. And that is good. The Raptors have gone 7 of 15 from the field here in the third quarter. Defense, 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 defense. Johnson left side. Clock at 6. It's stolen by Bogut. Iguodala right side. And it's out of bounds. The Raptors will take it the other way.
Man, I don't know what happened right there. He just basically walked out of bounds.
And some changes here for the Warriors. Harrison Barnes, he's checked in for Bogut. And it's Livingston in for Klay Thompson. And Toronto also making a switch. Luis Scola, he's checked in for Marc Gasol. So it's Toronto now. Pass to Carroll. Scola against Barnes. Scola passes to Baller. Fades back. Shot is off. The Warriors go the other way. Iguodala outside. The shot by Spates. Nobody around. That one falls. Coming off Iguodala's feet. Iguodala's got 4 assists in the game. On the wing, Johnson. Tries a 3. And it's Spates with the rebound. Warriors trail by 9. 1:43 left in the third quarter. Livingston, no luck.
And good defense there to play up and get a hand in the face.
Well, he's got a tough mindset. He's confident as a defender. And when you combine those two things, it makes it real hard to score on him.
Baller. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2.
Looking at the game, Baller has been having. He's got 10 points, and he's got 2 baskets from out in 3-point land.
And I'm sure they'd like to get a few more of those out of him.
This is his first chance at the line tonight. The first one falls. Some changes for Toronto. Risa comes in for Johnson. And it's Lowry in for Damari Carroll. Falls, so he hits both of them. We've got 1:28 left in the third. Here is Livingston. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Barnes dishes to Iguodala. Off target from outside.
Not good shot selection. Long range and a defender all up in your jersey.
And you know, that's just the kind of defensive work he's known for. I mean, he can take that shot away from you and does it more times than not.
Screen by Scola. Lowry kicks to Scola. Takes a three. Barnes grabs the miss. Barnes has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Good on the shot. Barbosa's got his second bucket of the night.
And that's how the coach would draw it up on the fast break from start to finish.
Yeah, and what a finish it was, guys. Really nicely done.
And so here's Toronto following the score by Golden State. Outside Lowry. And again, no good by Toronto.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
Making 10 of their last 12 points coming off assists.
You have to love the ball movement.
5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. He dishes it to Ariza. Passes it to Ball. Scola, a screen on Barbosa. Lock at six. Baller passes to Ibaka. Toronto working the ball around now. Barnes grabs the miss. Livingston, and the quarter ends with some stifling defense right there. The third quarter comes to a close. Raptors lead by 7. And coming up as soon as we return from break, the fourth quarter gets underway. Thanks for joining us, folks. The fourth quarter of play should begin momentarily. Warriors trail by 7. The Splash Brothers are the guards. The defensive stalwarts, Green and Bogut, are down low. And it's Barnes in at the threesome. So that's the group out there for Golden State. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way. Marc Gasol is checked in for the Raptors. And that one misses. Raptors leading by 5. They get it back. Misses the layup. He had him with that bump fake. The Warriors shooting in this game, 45%. Lowry against Curry. Screen by Bogut. They double-team Curry. Bogut dishes to Green. Just 5 on the clock. Back to Bogut. Thompson from long range. It's hauled in by the Raptors. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. Pass to Ball from deep. That's good. Baller's got 10 points here in the second half.
Add another triple to their second half total.
They came out of the break just dropping bombs and just are not letting up at all.
Now here's Barnes. Pass to Bogut. And again, no good by Golden State.
Yeah, good tough D there to get a hand up and force that miss.
That's example number one of why he is such a strong defensive player and why he has such a great defensive reputation.
Three-pointers are killing them at this point, and they haven't been able to respond at the other end.
Yeah, and Greg, you know, the only way that's going to turn around defensively is by stopping the outside shot, not getting into a shootout. They're not going to out-shoot out this team.
And Green gets it to go.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
Raptors leading by nine. Lowry drives in. It's stolen by Bogut. Outside Curry. Screen by Bogut. They double-team Curry. Outside Green. Good on the three-point shot. Green's got 5 points in the quarter.
You might not think of him as a laser three-point shooter, but that shot was there for him, and he had to take it.
Lowry passes to Ball. Pulls up on the wing, and again it's Toronto converting. We're in the final quarter of play here, 3 minutes in. Curry kicks to Green. Bogut high post. To the left side wing. Six on the shot clock. Barnes can't get it to go.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
Lowry kicks to Gasol. Ariza has the open look. Good, and the assist goes to Gasol. And now it's an 11-point Toronto lead.
And really, as the three-pointers keep dropping, you get the sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense.
Yeah, and they either have been unwilling or unable to take that shot away.
And he can time his passes so perfectly. Wow, what an assist.
Toronto leading by nine. Lowry with the ball. Pass the ball. There's the feed to Gasol. Takes the turnaround J, and the rebound goes to the Warriors. Thompson's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Barnes dishes to Kerr. And that one's good.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to the rim.
Raptors have gone 4-7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. Passes it to Pete. To the inside. And Gasol with the dunk.
And very little fight put up by the defense as he made his way to the bucket for the jam.
They did seem to take the cautious approach, Greg, when it came to defending that one. You're right.
And guys, it's not the time for caution now. I mean, they've got to be aggressive and take some risk to see if they can cut that lead down. Now that's finishing your work right there.
Powerful two-hand jam. You're right.
And I tell you what, if he's got a few more of those in him, this lead will start shrinking even further.
Baller passes to Lowry. He's covered by Thompson. Can't get it to go. Warriors trail by seven. Down low, here's Curry. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. 17 points for Steph Curry.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
Toronto calls timeout. And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Yes, Kevin. Dwayne Casey was just going over the plan with his team. He wants to make sure they stay assertive and aggressive on the offensive end, saying, I don't want to sit on this lead. Let's build on it and not give them a chance of coming back. Guys?
And so here's Toronto. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. Lowry kicks to Carroll. P covered by Barnes. And it's Harrison Barnes with the foul. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, that's a tough call right there. And really a tough break for the D.
Greg, no problem for me with that call. I mean, he was still sliding right there.
Baller, he's checked in for Damari Carroll. Gasol dishes to Lowry. They set the pick and the pass to Baller. Four on the shot clock. Gasol a screen. Here's Baller. But they'll get another chance. Back to Lowry. They shoot again. Bullseye! And the Raptors lead by seven.
And they hold a huge advantage on the backboard.
Greg, and that's been the key to this lead. I mean, they've really dominated the glass.
Now, here's Green. Thompson inside the line. Offensive rebound.
Early on, he tried to shoot his way out of this funk. But later in the game now, he might want to just give it up and look for his teammates to do the scoring.
Gasol against Bogut. Gasol passes to Pete. And stolen by Barnes. And here we go with Thompson running it up the court. And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
Yeah, how about the sharp steal and then run out? It looks like they're ready to put the hammer down.
Well, we've been waiting for one of these teams, Greg, to pull away. Maybe that'll be a springboard for them.
Could be. A dunk like that coming off a great defensive play has to build some momentum.
So it's Toronto now, following the score by Golden State. Baller passes to Gasol. It's hauled in by Bogut. Bogut's got six rebounds here tonight. And Thompson kicks to Barnes. Coming off the assist from Thompson. And now just a three-point Toronto lead.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Purposeful passing it is, partner. Their last 10 points have all come off assists.
Pass to Ball. Here's P. And that's collected by Bogut. Bogut's got seven rebounds in the game. Curry dishes to Barnes. And he banks in the layup. Barnes has got 6 points in the quarter.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 points coming from inside the painted area.
And really something that the defense has to address.
And Toronto has possession. They lead by one. Gasol passes to Ball. He feeds it to Lowry. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time.
And you can tolerate gaffes like that sometimes, but in a close game, man, I tell you what, that really hurts.
Golden State's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Guy is a potent offense right now.
Yeah, Kevin, really the offense is flowing quite nicely right now.
You know what, guys, and they're playing with a certain amount of assuredness in their game. That type of confidence is what leads teams to having success.
Just five to shoot. Good. By Lowry. Toronto's gone 3-5 from beyond the arc since the final quarter's gotten underway. Passes it to Pete. Puts up the baby hook. Pulled the shot a little up, but the bounce goes his way. And the Raptors lead by three.
You know, it's really going to be all about hard work from this point on. And they worked hard to create that high-quality shot right there.
No question. That's their goal down the stretch here. I think finding those close-range rhythm shots.
Here's Lowry. Harrison Barnes picking up that last basket. Toronto calls timeout.
Yeah, too many easy buckets coming from inside, and I think he wants to make that a point of emphasis.
I would certainly think so. I mean, if they keep giving up those kinds of easy looks inside, they'll be in big trouble.
All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Hi, Kevin. Steve Kerr was just going over the plan with his team. He told the team he wanted their offense to run through Green. Coach is calling on him to play a big role in the offense for the rest of this game, to really be one of the key guys for them down the stretch. Guys, they're operating under the principle that it's never too late to fine-tune the game plan. Kevin, over to you.
Always great to hear from you, Doris. Good D by Johnson.
Not sure if he just ran out of gas or what, Kevin, but he's been awful ever since the second half started. Not even been a factor.
And they'll be counting on even more points from him. That's essential if they're going to pull this game out.
Ball. He's covered by Thompson. Stolen by Thompson. And Curry has it in the corner. Nice move. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. That one is on a reason.
Take a look at what Curry's done. He has 17 points and 10 assists also. His fourth quarter performance, impressive.
He has really picked it up as we've come down the stretch.
And a chance for just a second to check out the scoring breakdown for the Warriors.
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous. Very unselfish.
Yeah, but I also like the balance because they're doing a great job of getting inside and converting around the rim. I really like their aggressiveness.
Good on the first, and that will put them up by two. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 3-point game.
What a clutch performance. He loves being in these situations, just relishes the opportunity. A lot of guys say they do, but you can see it in his face. He truly does.
Inside. Lowry passes to Pete. Shot clock at 6. Back to Lowry. Nails the wide-open jump shot. Timeout called the Warriors. They're up by one. 1:22 left in the fourth quarter. .22 left in the fourth quarter. Green, the screen. Curry kicks to Thompson. No good on the triple. Toronto trailer. Outside Lowry. And there's the pass to Pete. It's stolen by Green. Now Curry. 55 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Some nice passing by Golden State. Baller, he's covered by Thompson. Baller passes to Pete. And he was camped in the lane there, and he gets the 3-second call. We've got 33 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, they're not going to be in any rush on this possession.
Not with the lead. I mean, now's the time to use the clock to your advantage. Take the time. Milk the clock a little bit.
Here's Ariza.
Yes!
Clutch shot right there. That could be the difference maker.
Indeed, it might be a big, huge moment in this game right there.
Now a timeout called by Golden State. They're losing by one. 20 seconds left in the fourth. What's your take, guys?
You know what? Enough time that they can run whatever play they're most comfortable with.
Definitely. I mean, they're in good shape here, in my opinion. Shot clock's off, but still enough time left on the game clock to really run your normal set here.
Thompson kicks to Curry. Here's Green. And so it looks like the Warriors will retain possession here. Here's Barnes. It's Curry with the drive. And they commit an intentional foul. It's another one of those so they can get into the penalty.
Had to foul, and on that occasion to stop the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
And you know what, Greg? Who knows? A few misses at the stripe, and they're right there within range. You know, late game free throws are a lot different than early game free throws in terms of making.
One, and that will put them up by two. He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in. Timeout called, the Warriors. They're trailing by two. 8 seconds left to play in the final quarter. What do you think, guys?
You know what? You can go for the three to win or the two to tie. What's your choice in a situation like this, Clark?
Well, I don't think you set that decision in stone and anchor it in this timeout. You see how things play out. You're going to try to get a good, quick shot. And if it's a good three with a good shooter, let it fly. If it's something in the paint, then you take that. But it's about being a good, quick shot in this situation.
Now a timeout called by Golden State. They're trailing by two. 8 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Guys, your thoughts?
And it all comes down to this. Still enough time on the clock that they should be able to get a real good look.
Yeah, and in this case, you debate often. You hear guys debate whether to take a two for the tie or a three to win. In my case, with this situation, I think you go hard inside and see if you can get a good shot in close.
No good.
I mean, you know what? Very close to a three-point play right there.
Yeah, he almost got that one down. I mean, those are the kind of aggressive plays coaches love to see.
Good on the first, and that narrows the gap to one. And both free throws good for Curry.
You can't have any more pressure on you than he had at the line right there. Shows you what he's made up as he's able to tie it up.
And the Raptors call time here. Lowry for three. Oh, couldn't sink the shot, and we're going to overtime. Time expires, and we're going to overtime. And we'll be back with you right after. If you're just joining us, the intensity has really heated up in this one as we've watched this one go now to overtime. And it's the Warriors to start out. And always a good ride in these post-regulation battles. This overtime now looking to be an exciting one. Courtesy of Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineup for us now in overtime. So the Raptors five right now. They've got Marc Gasol. He out there with Trevor Ariza. Then there's Lowry. And it's Baller in at the shooting guard. And here's Lowry after the three-pointer from Klay Thompson. Fires the three. It's rebounded by Golden State.
Some of the shots he's taken have been real head scratches. I mean, come on. He's out there playing like it's a game of horse at the park.
Good D by Ariza.
Sure what he was thinking about on that shot. That is not high IQ basketball.
Not at all. I mean, he shouldn't even have considered taking that shot. Just a poor choice there.
Thompson dishes to Bogut. Curry against Ariza. Now here's Curry. Defense is right there. Feeds to Thompson. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Now it's a six-point Warrior lead. Lowry passes to Pete. We're in overtime and 90 seconds gone here in what has been a great one so far.
This is not the slam dunk contest. You don't get do-over. You got to finish the job.
I mean, that can happen to anyone, but it's ugly every time it does.
Yeah, it is unfortunate, embarrassing. He just lost his concentration for a split second. That's all it took.
Now, here's Curry. Just about 2 minutes in now to this overtime period. What a game. There's the dish to Thompson. Fires for three. Again, the miss by Thompson. Raptors trail by four. Time now for an injury report. Right now, let's get an update on Klay Thompson. Doris, what's his status?
Kevin, the Warriors' head athletic trainer gave me an update. He said he's having back spasms, and it's causing him a lot of pain. To have an injury like this happen in the NBA Finals is a tough blow for him and his team. They're up against it right now, Kevin.
All right, Doris, really appreciate you finding out how he's doing.
And, you know, I know everyone is rooting for him to make a quick and full recovery.
Absolutely. I mean, his teammates want him back out there as much as he wants to be back out there.
The free throw drops for Curry. Toronto calls timeout. We're in OT here with just over 2.5 minutes gone by. Good looking screen by Gasol. Ball, he's covered by Thompson. Shot clock at six. Fires the three. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Bogut's got 9 rebounds now tonight. Screen by Bogut. Now here's Curry. He's covered closely. The drive by Iguodala. Out to Thompson. one fall. Coming off Iguodala's feed. And that's 18 points for Klay Thompson.
Well, check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates that are clearly on the same page.
Pass to Pete. Outside Lowry. Here's Baller. Here's Gasol. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
And Kevin, the knack for the offensive rebound, a big part of what makes this guy special.
Not to mention, Greg, his ability to finish with strength just like that.
Yeah, he's an invaluable asset for them to have. No question about it.
Looking at the clock, just over 3.5 minutes into OT. Green with the ball. Lowry picks him up. Curry kicks to Green. Back to Curry. Well-timed pass, and it goes straight to the bucket for the layup. Curry's got the lead up to 9 now for the Warriors. Toronto's gone ice cold from three-point land. 0-for-4 since regulation ended. He passes to Lowry. Dishes it to Gasol. The turnaround, and that one's good. And he's now got the double-double. 10 points and 12 rebounds.
Oh, the turnaround jumper. That was just beautiful.
And stolen by Ariza. It's stolen by Curry. And Iguodala with the basket, the assist by Curry. And the Warriors lead by 9.
I don't want to say they're trying to run up the score here, but they do keep adding to the lead.
Well, I know you don't want to say it, but I will, partner. I mean, they're trying to run the score up here. It's plain and simple. They're trying to throw salt all in that wound.
Here's Thompson. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Clock at 5. Outside Curry. No good, and tight defense there bothered that shot. Toronto calls timeout. They're behind by 6. 9 seconds left in overtime. Guys, your thoughts?
And they still got a little time to play with, so a 3 and a quick foul make things interesting.
Yeah, but they need some help. They're going to need some help any way you look at it. I mean, they're hoping for some missed free throws at the other end.
Off the inbound, it's money from deep. Now a timeout called by Golden State. They lead by 3. 7 seconds left in overtime. Foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet. And it's the Warriors with the ball. And he commits the intentional foul. Free throw is good, and that gives them a 4-point cushion. And so both free throws are good. And it's a 5-point game.
That ought to do it. I think any chance for a miracle comeback just went out the window with those freebies.
Toronto calls timeout. They trail by 5. 3 seconds left in the first overtime. Action has been terrific. What do you think, guys?
You know, I think he's just trying to send his team a message. You know, not willing to give up on this game just yet. Just trying to instill that fight in this group.
Yeah, hey, I'm all for giving messages and teaching lessons, and I respect that. But at some point, if it's over, it's over. I mean, you need to be looking at the next one. This one's done. Forget about it. Let's move on.
Toronto calls timeout. They're down by 5. 3 seconds left in the first overtime. Guys, your thoughts?
Yeah, they can call all the timeouts they want, but really, I don't think it matters at this point.
Yeah, I'm ready to go home just like the players are. There's nothing they can do to salvage this one right now. Let's go. Get out of here. Game done.
You summed it up.
I was going to say, yeah, I don't think we need to comment after that.
Adios. And that's it, folks. The Golden State Warriors have won it all.
Well, they did it. And as they celebrate, you can just see the relief, the exhilaration that comes with winning it all.
And Clark, you have to hand it to the entire organization. They work together to get right here.
And guys, what a reward for the fan base. I mean, I know one thing. They're going to enjoy this memory for a long, long time.
And we have enjoyed our time with you folks all season long. This is Kevin Harlan saying so long. Have a wonderful summer.